Ready? Because this is it. Well, it's not it, but it's something very big. And it's not quite ready yet, but I wanted to see how you're doing. What I've got is a Flisa Bank franchise. And it's nothing too complicated. There's no buy-in. Now, normally, there would be a buy-in. You would put in money up front, we would arrange the job, and you would pull it off. But this time, I'll cover the upfront costs. Call it the price of getting a look at you. And there's no risk to you. Unless, of course, you count getting locked up or shot. So, you ready? And what do you think? You got questions, comments, concerns? All right. What are you waiting for? Let's go see this place. Let's go. There's a Flisa franchise on the Western Highway near Chumash. Take us there. Word of warning, we're on the job right now, so don't let the cops notice you. If they come after us, we call it off. So, my taciturn friends, I suppose you want to know how we're doing this. Well, funny you should ask. We're driving out to the bank, taking a look at it, picking up some equipment, and then heading back to make our plans. Not very complex at all. We're not going in, we're not poking it with a stick. We're just sitting back and taking a look. You see, I like my scores like I like my dates. Across the street and unaware they're being watched. All right, so why this bank over all the other banks in the state? Why does fortune favor this one? Another good question. You're full of good questions. You're like a child whose parents think it's clever, or the IRS. Well, this bank's got some safety deposit boxes, and in one of those safety deposit boxes are some bonds being hidden from the tax man that no one's gonna report missing. All starting to make sense. Security should be light, well, relatively light. Light if your daydreams are raids on the Union Depository. Quite heavy if your day job is turning over liquor stores and gas stations. And the bonds in the box will be worth more than a few rumpled notes from a till, so the minor escalation is worth it, if you can handle it. Plus, you know, the sea view, nothing like staring at the ocean while you contemplate money and power. Incarceration, homicide, you know, all those weighty issues surrounding your first foray into serious armed robbery. I'm assuming you're kind of a cerebral crew, because otherwise this whole not-talking deal just kind of puts you on the spectrum, right? Okay, well, how about we just get there and see where we're at? Shit! See where we're at. There it is. Take a look. Drink it in. I've patched into their security feed on my cell. Take a look. What are we looking at? Small joint. Not much security. Staff won't give a crap. Especially about the deposit boxes. Customers will probably be thinking how to turn this into a screenplay. The boxes are in the back behind a safe door. We want box number 167. Yeah, it's right on the highway with good access. That works for you. You can get out quick. But it'll also work for the cops. Speed up their response time. Okay? Okay. Enough of this peeper crap. Let's go to the garment factory. Now, when you hit the bank, you're gonna need to hack into its security system. I've written a neat little program that'll do most of the work for you, but it's probably a good idea for you to familiarize yourselves with it. You, in the passenger seat. I've sent it to your phone. Now take it for a dry run, keep your hands steady, and maybe the wet run won't be a disaster. Calling Paige. She's my assistant. First she's gonna get us what we need, then she's gonna saw me in half. No? Didn't like that one? You don't make it easy.
You're a really bad driver!
Paige, it's Lester. The place looked good. Nothing we weren't expecting. Can you get the intel together? Hard copies to go on a notice board. Yeah, plus all the equipment we spoke about. I'll be over to collect it with those people. Yeah. Charming as ever. Okay, see you soon. She's loading the hardware into the back of a truck. Tools for the job, things for you to wear.
Excuse me!
Idiot. Things for you to wear. On a job, your attire will depend on the role you're performing. As a job gets more complicated, so will the uniforms. If you're likely to be seen by civilians, you'll be provided with a couple of masks. Then, when you go into the bank, you can choose one that goes with your eyes. And hey, there's the added bonus of none of your favorite comic convention outfits being linked to a major crime. Whoop-dee-doo. Where were we? Masks. Paige. Oh, yeah. We'll go over there, pick her up, and go back to your place to plan this thing. I can talk with you through the planning board later. That might be helped by a visual aid. The rest is pretty self-explanatory. Listen to me, do what I say. Bullets go in here, come out. There she is. You leave my car here, take the truck.
Nice to meet you.
Come on, back to your place. Is it all there?
I think so. You want to get out and check? Go down the inventory? Or are you happy sitting there making a perfect butt imprint in your easy wipe seat?
I'll take your word for it.
Thank you. It should all be there. The clothes, guns, headsets, holdalls, masks, the drill, the files with all the photos and surveillance work. Hey, there's enough here to make us all look real suspicious. Nice little conspiracy to commit robbery charge waiting to happen.
What, they're gonna charge us with thought crime?
Not so much thought as everything but the deed crime. We'd be caught with our pants down and a hard-on out to here.
Well, we're not getting caught. These are professionals.
So I hear. The cheapest professionals money can buy.
Look out!
The cheapest professionals money can buy.
I like to think of it as investing in new talent. And until you and me start playing low-rent Bonnie and Clyde, that's the way it's gotta be. She didn't mean anything by that, by the way. She's just a little brusque.
If they were offended, they would have said something.
Okay. Now, Paige will set up a board for you, won't you, Paige?
I'd let you do it if you could reach. I mean, I didn't see any milk crates for you to stand on.
The most important thing to look for in an employee is respect. You can't get anything done without respect. Where was I? The room. And Paige is setting up this board on which you will plan your scores. You'll use it to set out all the prep work you need to do, select your crew, figure out how the take from a score should be split up. See, you need a crew to take a score. But only one person can be in charge. Respect. Isn't that right, Paige?
Blow me.
All right. You're only going to need one thing for this job. It's a high-speed armored car. Now, instead of getting one legitimately and leaving a nice long paper trail to your front door, you're going to be jacking one from a nasty Korean crew and leaving a nice long paper trail to their door instead.
This is good to go.
Okay. Here's your board. Good. And when you're ready to move on the car, go over it. Study the plan. Tick it off the list. You must be methodical. This isn't just a dumb crime. Well, there is an element of that, huh? Oh. And when you've got the car, we'll come back here and talk bank jobs. Bank jobs.
Can you hear me? I'll be here to talk you through all these jobs. What do we got here? The car. Okay. You're on the way to Del Perro. A Koreatown stick-up crew's been using a parking lot as a base for scores. They're into extortion, credit fraud, stolen cars, and some mini major robberies. I'd expect them to be packing, and I'd expect them to be paranoid. Come to think of it, you won't find a bulletproof car in the hands of anyone who doesn't have a healthy dose of paranoia. So be careful. Drop any cops or gangsters or whoever you've got coming after you and bring it to my garment factory. And try not to damage the car too much. You can't rob a bank in a wrecked car.
Okay, I'll look after this. Lester will come by your place when you're ready to go.
Show America deserves fame or shame.
The winner gets $1 million and tours around the country before disappearing back to bitter obscurity.
The finals continue with Shemale Bop.
You guys are going to the finals.
Mimes on Fire.
Woo! What a talent. I have never seen someone set fire to their
your first time. You know, the first times, well, it's never easy. There won't exactly be fireworks, you know. It'll be vaguely awkward and disappointing, you know. You'll probably stick the wrong thing in the wrong part, and you'll finish too early, and you won't be able to make eye contact afterwards. But new worlds will open up. Something will have changed, you know. New opportunities, new risks. And that's when you'll remember that old Uncle Lester was here for you, holding your hand, you know, guiding you through it. And then you'll feel a little creeped out, but you're going to repress it. Squash it down. And we'll never talk about it, okay? Okay? Okay. First time. Blisa! Woo! It's a two-man score, right? One of you drives, keeps the heat off of you. The other goes into the bank, goes to the specific safety deposit box. Then you get out of there, you get in that fast armored car, and you get the hell out of that place. Then once you're clean, once you got no heat on you, come see me, give me the box, and you get paid. Okay. You know, like I said, it is your first time, so don't expect too much. There are wild, insane, mind-blowing orgies in your future. Orgies! But, you know, we all gotta start somewhere. Good luck!
stomach and a light film of sweat on my upper lip. You know where you left the car. At least I hope you do. You weren't drunk on painkillers, were you? No, that was me. Okay, get the car, then move on to the bank. Got the wheels? All right, go to the bank. Driller, start hacking their network. You need to establish a connection before you get to the bank. Then you'll be able to trigger the vault door remotely. The hacking program's cleaning up after you, so you can take as many shots as you want and they won't know they're being attacked. Once you walk through those doors, there's no turning back. Well, actually, there's no turning back right now because I've put a lot of work into this and I'll be really, really annoyed with you if you don't go through with it. You know, I'd probably refuse to speak to you for a week and then spread nasty rumors behind your back and maybe set up a Life Invader page about what a creep you are. You know, it'd be scarier if I threatened to kill you, wouldn't it? But in the age of the internet, when nothing is forgotten and humiliation is worse than death, in a way... No, it's not, is it? I should have made a death threat, or like, at least a mutilation threat. Said I'd, you know, cut off your nose, or I'd use your ass for an ashtray, or do something with your tongue. Not that you use your tongue. The next pair of mutes I try to help into a career of crime, I'll make sure I threaten. So, since we're actually doing this, I'm gonna talk you through it one last time. We've given you pump-action shotguns to take in. They should look intimidating enough. You both go in. You go in hard. There are four security cameras in the foyer. Driver, take them out as soon as you walk in the door. Then you're on crowd control. Driller, when you're in the network, you'll be able to open the vault door on your phone. Go back to the safety deposit room and start drilling. You get the box, come out of there, get in the car, and hit the road. Now, part of the money I put up for this job went to getting you out clean. I hired the best guy in the business to get you away from the cops. He, wasn't cheap, nor the expenses he submitted. But, you know, only the best. When you're out of the bank, all you gotta do is get to him and he'll get you out. You think you can manage that? Well, we're all about to find out. While your partner's in the back.
Whatever you want.
And don't kill any witnesses, okay? No bodies, not now.
Please, no!
Okay.
I'll do what you say.
Stay in control. If they think you're weak, they might try something.
I do not like this.
Let the hostages know what happens to heroes, yeah? This ain't the movies.
Okay, I get it. We mic it on the news. Yeah!
I get it.
Make it stop!
You made your point.
I knew we should...
Okay.
Chill out! Please, no! This ain't cool! Hey, I'm cool! Okay, I get it!
Someone help us!
Crap! Chill out!
about the cops. Just get to the bridge. Hey, come in. This is your getaway guy. Lester tells me you were inbound. Keep driving for the bridge. I got this under control.
Show it to me. Yes, it is the holiday season at the Crest residence, and Daddy's out drinking. Say, past. If that thing I talked about comes up, I'll call you in. In the meantime, if anyone comes to me, I'll mention you as a reliable pair of hands. Hey! For the first time, that wasn't bad, but don't get clingy.